Colleagues, welcome back. In this video, I am going to add content to my book, that my Moodle book that I just created in the previous video. So if you look here at my screen, you would see that I have created the book here. Make sure that your editor is switched on like mine, and then if you click on this book, then we are going to add content there. Then you see this is the first chapter, and in that chapter we were going to add the introduction to this particular book. So let's just add the introduction there, and this is now the very first chapter that we are adding. So what I'm gonna do is I will be fetching content from a Word document that I have created, and then I'm just gonna copy and paste. So I just gonna work with the introduction there, so that I just set my foundation, my to the course, that my students know what this is about. So I will then just quickly, after I have copied from my Word document, and we spoke about this earlier, that you click, you select the content that you want to copy from the Word document, and then you click simultaneously, you press the Control key and the C key, and then we're just gonna paste it in here. We're gonna paste it in, and this is my introduction. And then I would say save changes, and there you will see there is my introduction on the very right hand side. So I am going to add a chapter to that introduction. So I click here on the add button, and then I am going to go back to my document, which I have prepared already, and so that I can continue with the adding my content. So yeah, I have a heading that I will be what this particular page or this chapter is about, and then I am just going to, you know, get my information, what I would like to add to that one. So I'm copying, and then I go into my content, and then I paste my content into that box. We can just so that there is some spacing between the paragraphs. So I have now taken quite a number of quite a lot of the content, but there I have made some spaces so that my students are able to read it easily, and not you know, getting lost while they are reading. Let me just check back here and make sure that my, so you see it appears much better now after I have just added that line spaces, and then I will just save my, the heading is not here. Let me just add the heading there. It's about carbon and greenhouses, gases. So yeah, I'm gonna put my heading there, and this is a new chapter, and then I am going to save it, and then you see here, this is what it looks like. If you look there, then this is about carbon dioxide. So I'm gonna have a last page to add, which is now not a new chapter, but it is going to be a subject chapter underneath that one that we just added. So we're going to copy our content and then we are moving back to where we were. And I am going to add a subchapter. So let us just quickly paste the content there and let's add the spacing there where we would want the spacing so that our work is just a little bit nicely chunked and nicely displayed. We don't want the students to become discouraged because of too much content that has been given to the students, but we want them to enjoy what is being provided to them. So if you see what difference that this makes, if you just chunk it or just present it nicely in paragraphs. So we're just going to have here a heading quickly also, but it's a subchapter, and then we're just going to save it. And so you will see here the table of content is now growing longer there. It's becoming longer there. So we have now added, you know, two chapters and also a subchapter to it. So this is what my book looks like. And I am going to just going back to my landing page. Yeah, I'm going back to my landing page. Here is topic one. And there is my book. My book has got these three items in it. I have two chapters and one subchapter. Colleagues, we have now come to the end of part two, and the next video is part three, also on books. Thank you so much, and bye-bye.